So how did I go from an engineering career to a data analyst career without going back to school and without spending a kobo? In today's video, I'm going to be sharing my story and give you some advice if you're looking to go down this journey. Hey, what's up guys? Welcome to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Wale and I'm a data analyst working here in Lagos, Nigeria. Before we get started in the video, definitely check out the description area for timestamps if you want to jump to any specific area of this video. I'd also leave links to some of the resources and courses I use to get started. And finally, do show some love by smashing the like button and also subscribe if you love content like this. All right, let's jump straight into it. A little backstory about my life as an engineer. I never thought I would become a data analyst. I remember how excited I was after graduating with a mechanical engineering degree, and I was looking forward to working in the oil and gas industry. So I hurriedly, as many of us at that time, went ahead to the UK to complete my master's degree in subsea pipeline engineering. Interestingly, I got my first job in the oil and gas, and I was well on my way to achieving my big dream of working in the oil and gas industry. I had barely settled down into my job when crude oil prices began to go south. The company I worked for at that time had to lay off several employees, and unfortunately, I was one of them. After I got laid off, I was determined not to let this dream die, so I was aggressively applying for jobs, but unfortunately, I wasn't getting any. And so after sitting at home for about 18 months of not securing an oil and gas job, living under my parents' roof, eating my parents' food as a 27-year-old, I decided it was time to let go of my oil and gas dream and start a new journey as a data analyst. So how do you become a data analyst? To become a data analyst, there are a few key skills that you need to learn before picking up your first online course. The first skill is you must have an analytical mindset, and that's why it's called an analyst. If you look up the meaning of analyst in Google, it says someone whose job is to study or examine something in detail. To examine something in detail, you must be willing to ask questions that might lead to useful insights. The second skill you need to have is the skill to interpret numbers in a way that is easy to understand. A lot of people do not like the sight of numbers. They get confused and anxious when presented with numbers flying everywhere. So your job is to help them understand and help them see those intimidating numbers in a fun and exciting way. Third skill is you must be ready to keep learning new stuff every day to up your skill set. And that's because the data science field is a very dynamic field. The rate at which data is being generated all around the world is mind-boggling. And at such rates, data could come in varying formats, sizes, shapes, and forms. For example, formats like numbers, words, dates, pictures, audio recording, or even a combination of all of this would require specialized softwares or programming language for analysis. There are multiple and different tools to analyze data out there. For low volume data in number formats, like tools like Microsoft Excel, SQL, Python, R are very useful. While for big data with huge volume and complex formats with pictures, videos, audio recordings, then tools like Hadoop, Scala, Java, Python, R will be useful. I know it's easy to get intimidated by all these tools, especially for a beginner, but do not be intimidated. All you need is to pick one and master it. As you go along, you'll begin to pick up other tools naturally. I normally encourage anyone to start with Microsoft Excel. Microsoft Excel is the most widely used data analysis tool. It is used by many corporate organizations as a standard analysis tool. There are many free resources on Microsoft Excel that you can study on the internet to get you started. Now, after you've mastered Microsoft Excel, you can then graduate into learning SQL, Python, R, and these programming languages will take you much deeper into manipulating larger volumes of data. Okay, so for you to get started, all you need is a computer, an internet connection, and a bunch of online courses to get you started. I'll leave in the description below links to some of the resources I used. Some of them are free, some might require you to pay a small fee. Alright, so after you're done with all your courses, it's time to update your resume and your LinkedIn profile. Create a one-page resume highlighting your best skills, including all your certificates. At this point, if you're really good at Microsoft Excel, then you should have it mentioned multiple times in your resume. So divide your work experience section into relevant and other work experiences. For relevant work experience, put it at the top of the page so that that's the first thing anyone sees. If you do not have any relevant work experience yet, use your capstone project as a work experience. Now, remove irrelevant work experience or skills into the other work experience section and move it to the bottom of the page. It is not relevant anymore, but it is important so anyone reviewing your resume can see your work history. You can also set up a project portfolio where you can showcase your project by hosting it online. There's a guy on YouTube called Alex the Analyst that expands on this in much detail. I'll leave his YouTube channel in the description below to learn more about that. All right, to conclude, if you're looking to begin this journey, then know that a career as a data analyst is both an interesting and a rewarding one. You'd get to acquire in-depth insights to how businesses make decisions just by looking at their data. And also, it is one of the most, if not the most, in-demand job of the century. So you're sure to never be out of job for a long time. And lastly, being a data analyst can keep you in close proximity to management, and this increases your chances of becoming a key decision maker for your organization. All right, so I hope you've learned something. If you did, please smash the like button. It really means a lot. Thanks guys for watching. See you in the next one. Bye.